Alright, so once our system is detecting the device, now if you watch carefully the desired capabilities which we have defined in the initial lectures to run an emulator, and this is our app, that's fine, and this is the device name, and here is the where you need to change. So earlier you are asking your Appium script to go and verify whether Rahul emulator exists and do my automation there, but here we are not depending on any emulator, right? We are depending on real device. So for any real device, simply let me comment this and write in the next step. Okay, I don't want to delete that again. Okay, so simply say Android device, that's it. You are not specifically targeting any emulator or device with name. You are just saying that go and find Android device. Okay, so then it go and hits the ADB devices and see that one device is connected and listening to this development machine, and it go and executes all your tests in that real device. Okay, whatever device you connected with your machine. Okay, so earlier you are specific on that emulator and you know that emulator name. So that's why you are writing this. And now just forget about all the names, just say Android device and connect your device to your laptop and run your test. Automatically all your test case execution will route to your real device. That's it. There is no specific code or there is no specific process to execute all this. There's only one single step change. Change this to Android device and route all your test cases to the real device. Okay. So that's the very convenient way Appium guys has provided us with simple capability step. Alright, so let me go to any of our tests. Okay, this is our test, right? Basics. So, okay, so this is not the thing. Extends base. Okay, so I'm just working on something earlier. Right, so the capabilities we are picking up from here. And then we are executing that. Now in this capabilities method, I changed emulator to real device, right? I updated the step. And now when I run this basic test of going and clicking on preference, checkboxes, edit button, it should actually route to real device, not emulator, because we have changed the capabilities from specific emulator to a real device. So let me run this test. Before that, let me go and start Appium server because I have not yet started it. Appium. Okay. Alright, server is started and my mobile is ready for execution. Let me say basics run as Java application. Click on OK. And now go to your mobile. Okay. I need to check logs as well. Okay, one device connected. It's still trying to find the device. Okay, it got now. And it's trying to push. You see that? In real device, I connected through TeamViewer. You see that how it is executing Wi-Fi, clicking on it, and it will enter hello. Same thing we have seen in the emulator earlier, right? And I'm doing same test execution without changing anything. Okay, just one step, that is Android device. You see that? Completed execution. It's a 200 pass, and that's how you can route all your tests. Okay, I'll not going to specific every test and explain that, because just change a single step and what all test cases you developed till now for practice in running an emulator, run all them in real device and see. Okay, but let's make it generic. Okay, rather than commenting every time, I'll tell you how you do in real time. In real-time projects, you cannot go and comment all the time, right? So what I'll say, I'll pass one parameters to the string method device. Okay, so I will say if device dot equals to emulator, then execute emulator. else, you can, by default, if it is not emulator, it's a real device, right? But still, let's try to say, else if device dot equals to real, and execute this. Okay, I'm not hard coding or I'm not commenting anything. I'm just saying to my capabilities that whatever the parameter you are sending as part of capabilities, if it is emulator, and then use this. If it is real device, then go and execute this. Okay, now I'll go to my basics method and you will see the error here. Did we update the right file? Yeah, capabilities device. Here, say real. Okay, so it says create methodability string. Oops, that's what we did here, base. Save the file. Okay, I did not save it earlier. And if we go to basics, you see that now all the tests are showing error because now this capabilities method expecting one parameter. That's how I configured this method. So this method needs one parameter. Based upon the parameter, it decides whether to execute on emulator or real. Okay, but all our previous classes, whatever we have written, we did not pass any parameter. Just because we changed this capability style, everything is failed except basics method. Because in basics, we are passing the correct parameter wise. Okay, so let me create one more class. I don't want to see all these tests failing. I'll create one fresh class, hybrid base. So hybrid in the sense, it's an app or real device, it takes care. Okay, so I will just uncomment all this because let's leave this test as it is. And I'll come to hybrid base. Okay, so my base, I'll extend hybrid base now. Okay, so basically our class taking the desired capabilities from hybrid base class. So when you go and open hybrid base, and this is the hybrid base, based upon the parameter you pass, when you say real, it go and executes this step and it will not execute this. When you say emulator, it executes emulator but not this. So we need to pass one string and that I am doing as a real. Okay, so I'm not commenting or hard coding anything. If tomorrow if someone comes and asks you, hey, can you please run this test in emulator? Just go and change emulator. That's it. It runs in emulator. If you want to do it in real, real. Because that's how we configured this method. Right. So now I'm saying run in real. And again, if I execute, it does the same thing. I can show you. Okay, so this is how you can route your all test cases, what you have learnt till now, into real. Okay, so in the next lecture, let me show you one example of scrolling in real device. It's still same as an emulator, but just I want to show one little slight variation. You see that? It's same again. Okay, so see you in the next lecture with one topic on real device. Thank you.